guys, welcome back to the sixth module of this data science course. And in today's session, we'll start off by understanding what is a confusion matrix. Then we'll look at some of the performance metrics which can be obtained from the confusion matrix, following which we'll understand the concept of thresholding. And finally, we'll implement the confusion matrix in R. So let's get started. So simply put, a confusion matrix helps you to describe the performance of a classification model. Now to get a confusion matrix, all we have to do is create a table of actual values and the predicted values. So the confusion matrix is quite simple to understand, but the related terminology can be a bit difficult. So we have different terms like true positive, false positive, true negative, and false negative. So let's understand all of those terms through this example. Now let's say there's a data set of all the patients in a hospital, and we build a logistic regression model on top of it to predict if the patient has cancer or not. Now there could be four possibilities. So let's look at all four. So let's start with true positives. So these are the cases in which the actual value is true and the predicted value is also true. That is, the patient has been diagnosed with cancer and the model also predicted that the patient has cancer. So next we have true negatives. And these are the cases in which the actual value is false and the predicted value is also false. That is, actually the patient doesn't have cancer and the model also predicted that the patient doesn't have cancer. Then we have false positives. So these are the cases in which the predicted value is true but the actual value is false. That is, the model predicted that the patient has cancer but in reality he doesn't. And this is also known as type 1 error. Finally, we have false negatives. And these are the cases in which the actual value is true, but the predicted value is false. That is, the model predicted that the patient does not have cancer, but in reality, he does. Now, consider the real-life implications of this. So there's a patient who has cancer, but you have incorrectly diagnosed that he doesn't have cancer. This is really dangerous, isn't it? So that is why we need to reduce the quantity of false negatives. So those were all of the terms in a confusion matrix. Now we'll look at some of the performance metrics. So we'll start with accuracy. So we can get the accuracy by dividing the true positives and true negatives with all of the values. So dividing this left diagonal over here with all of the values gives us the accuracy. Now let's take this example. So over here we have 100 true positives and 47 true negatives. So we'll add them up and divide the result with all of the values to get the accuracy. And thus, we get an accuracy of 0.72. So the next performance metric is precision. And this helps us to get the proportion of positive identifications which were actually correct. And we can get the precision of the model by dividing true positives with the sum of true positives and false positives. So over here we have 100 true positives and 30 false positives, and we'll get the precision by dividing 100 by 130. So the precision value is 0.76. And the next performance metric is recall. And this helps us to get the proportion of those actual positives which were identified correctly. And we can get recall by dividing true positives with the sum of true positives and false negatives. And over here we have 100 true positives and 25 false negatives. So we can get the recall value by dividing 100 with 125. And we get a recall value of 0.8. So those were the performance metrics. Now we'll understand why we need thresholding. Now when we build a logistic regression model, it returns a probability and not a direct result. So in order to map a logistic regression value to a binary category, you must define a classification threshold, and any value above the threshold is taken to be true and a value below the threshold is taken to be false. So let's understand the concept of thresholding with this example. Over here we are trying to find out if it will rain or not on the basis of other factors, and the threshold value which we have taken is 0.65. So in the first case, the logistic regression model gives a probability of 0.73 for rain, and since it is greater than the threshold value of 0.65, it will be classified as yes. And in the second case, the logistic regression model gives a probability of 0.59 for rain, And since it is less than the threshold value, it will be classified as no. So that was the concept of thresholding. Now it's time to implement a confusion matrix in R. So let's go to RStudio. Right, so we have RStudio right in front of us, and this is our same old customer churn data set. Right, so now to build a logistic regression model, we already know that we need to use the GLM function. And before that, again, we need to divide our entire data set into train and test sets. So for that, we would require the sample.split function, which is a part of CA tools package. So let me load that. So I have loaded the CA tools package. So now I can use the sample.split function. Right. And this time I'd want to understand how does the churn column vary with respect to the monthly charges column. Okay. So that is why I'll be splitting with respect to the churn column. And the split ratio which I'll take would be 0.65. And I will store this in split log. Okay. Now I can divide the data set by using the subset function. The first parameter is the entire data set. Now I'll use the split log. And wherever the value is true, I'll select all of those observations and store them in the train set. And similarly, wherever the value of split log is false, I'll select all of this observation from the customer churn data set and I will store it in test. Right. Now again, let me have a glance at number of rows of train in test. So n row of train would give me 4578, and n row of test has given me a value of 2465. Right. So we have our training and testing sets ready. Now it's time to build the model. So I'll use the GLM function. And the first parameter would be the formula. Okay, so let me get the formula over here. So it'll be churn, which is the dependent variable. I'll give a tilde symbol. And the independent variable would be monthly charges. So this is the formula, guys. Next, I need to give the data set onto which we are building a model. So data would be train. And finally, we have the family. So family over here would be binomial since we're building a logistic regression algorithm. And I will store this in mod log. Okay, so we have built a model. Now it's also time to predict the values. So I'll use the predict function. So the first parameter is the model which we've just built. Next, we have the new data set, which is nothing but our test set. And finally, we have the type of prediction, which would be response. So since we want the probabilities, the type would be response over here. And I will store this in result log. Okay. So there's a spelling mistake over here. So this needs to be response. Right. So it will be view of result log. So this is the predicted probability over here, guys. So let me have a look at the range. So it'll be range of result log. So let me see, what do I get? Right. So this is the range of probabilities. So it is from 14% to 44%. Right. So now I have got the range of probabilities. So now I can finally build the confusion matrix. And we've already learned that to build a confusion matrix, all we need to do is build a table of the actual values and the predicted values, right? So the actual values I'll get from the test set. So the churn column from the test set are my actual values, and the predicted values are stored in result log. And since these are actually probabilities, now I need to give a threshold value. So let's say the threshold value which I give is 0.3. okay, so anywhere where the probability is greater than 0.3, it'll be given true. And anywhere where the probability is less than 0.3, it'll be given false. And this will give me my confusion matrix. So this is our confusion matrix, guys. So now let me check the accuracy and let me see what it is. So for that, I need to divide the left diagonal by all of the values. So 1167 plus 339 divided by 1167 plus 339 plus 644 plus 315. So let me see, what do I get? Right. So the accuracy of the built model is 0.61. Now what I'll do is I will change the threshold value and make it to be 0.35. Okay, so this time let me check the accuracy. It will be 1459 plus 175, which is the left diagonal, divided by all of the values, which will be 1459 plus 175 plus 352 plus 479. Okay, so this time the accuracy is 66%, guys. Okay, so when the threshold value is 0.3, then the accuracy which we get is 61%, and when we take the threshold value to be 35%, the accuracy which we get is 66%. So this is how we can work with confusion matrix, and this brings us to the end of the session. Thanks for attending, and let's meet in the next class.